This is Reverend Shine David Coleman at Bethlehem District Association, Holy Week at South Park Missionary Baptist Church, where Pastor Craig Williams is intern and Pastor E.R. Williams Jr. is our leader. And Clifton Caldwell is our moderator. Look, we're making history. The first woman, elder, speaker of the Bethlehem District Association. Don't miss this. Don't miss this. KNTV, Channel 36 on WOW, on Comcast, on RCN, and 99 on AT&T. You can also YouTube us at Bethlehem District Association. God bless you. This is Reverend Shine David Coleman. Enjoy the program already in progress. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our speaker is Elder Lori Payton. Today, Minister Bonnie Ellis spoke.
I'm so glad Jesus lived in me. I'm so glad Jesus lived in me. Yes, and I'm so glad Jesus lived in me. I'm singing glory.
He didn't have to do it, y'all.
That's right.
But he came to say thank you.
Yeah.
up these men to stand where you are.
Yeah.
I'm going to turn it over to the preacher. I'm going to learn to obey orders. Amen. 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 She is a major. She can speak for herself. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. And the chief priest and scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children even crying in the temple, saying, "Hosanna to the Son of David." They were sore displeased and said unto him, "Hearest thou what these say?" And Jesus said unto them, "Yea, have you never read, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, thou hast perfected praise?"
Yes.
And he left them, went out of the city of Bethany, and he lodged there. You may be seated. And that's just what we're going to do. We're going to talk about this morning the significance of the triumphant entry. I looked up that word triumph, and that word means nothing less than a great victory.
Yeah.
A significant success.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
An awesome accomplishment that our Lord and Savior did when he rode into Jerusalem. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm using technology this morning, but I am ready. That triumphal entry of Jesus coming into Jerusalem that we know as Palm Sunday.
Yeah.
The Sunday before the crucifixion. It's the story of a triumphant entry that's one of the few incidents in the life of Jesus which appears in all four gospel accounts.
All
right. On that day when Jesus rode into Jerusalem was to make public his claim to be their Messiah.
All right.
And King of Israel in fulfillment of the Old Testament prophecy.
All right.
Zechariah 9:9. "Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, daughter of Jerusalem.
Yeah.
See, your king comes to you, righteous and having salvation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Gentle, yet riding on a donkey."
Yeah.
"On a colt, the foal of a donkey."
Yeah.
"Jesus rides into this capital city
yeah.
as a conquering king
yeah.
and is hailed by the people as such
yeah.
in the manner of that day.
Yeah.
The streets of Jerusalem, this royal city, are open to him. And like a king, he ascends to his palace."
All right.
It's not a temporal palace, amen, but it's the spiritual palace that is the temple.
Yeah.
Because he is a spiritual kingdom,
uh-huh.
he receives the worship and praise of the people because only he deserves it.
Yeah.
All right.
No, because he tells his disciples to be quiet about him.
All right.
But to shout his praises
yeah.
and worship him openly.
Yeah.
So much so they took garments and cloths and just began to lay them before the street.
Yeah.
That's a sign of royalty.
Yeah.
That's a sign of paying homage to the King of Kings
yeah.
and the Lord of Lords. And yet when Jesus rode into Jerusalem,
yeah.
he wept.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
my God. Mm-hmm. Because they were still looking for some time of revolt. From Rome, some of them all didn't realize who he really was.
Yeah.
Right. But others who had saw him raise Lazarus from the dead, they knew who was coming into town.
Yeah.
And the shouts rang loud, "Hosanna, Son of David, in the heights, blessed be the Lord." Hallelujah.
Yes,
what a triumphant entry this was.
Yeah.
What a way to come on in. And let it be known who he really was.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I thank him.
Thank you,
and then I said, "Lord, what's the significance of the donkey?" The donkey is a mild and gentle animal.
Yeah.
And Jesus used the donkey, and in my opinion, to let you know that he was the Prince of Peace.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Mild and meek.
Yes. Yes.
Yet he was unbroken.
Right.
This donkey. Amen.
Yeah.
Just like us.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
When we come to him and allow Jesus to lead us and guide us.
Yeah.
We might be stubborn. We might be rebellious. But when Jesus takes over,
right.
he'll subdue that nature.
Right.
Hallelujah. Our will become submitted to his will.
Yeah.
The triumphant entry
of
him
riding
into Jerusalem.
Yes,
glory be to God. But unfortunately, all this praise that the people lavished upon Jesus wasn't so much because they recognized him as their Savior from sin. I should have got my water. They welcomed him out of their desire for a messianic deliverer, someone who would lead them in the revolt against Rome. So many who, though they didn't believe in Christ as Savior, nevertheless hoped that perhaps he would be to them a great temporal deliverer. These are the ones who held him as king with their many hosannas, recognizing him as the son of David who came in the name of the Lord. But when he failed in their expectations, when he refused to lead them in the massive revolt against Roman occupiers, the crowd quickly turned on him. Isn't it interesting that today you're my friend and tomorrow you're my enemy? My God, today. Because within just a few more days, those hosannas are going to change into crucify him. Crucify him. My God, how we can change overnight in a second. Glory to God. Those who have held him as hero turn around and reject him and abandon him. Yet this story, my brothers and sisters, of the triumphal entry is one of a contrast. And those contrasts contain applications to the believer. It's the story of a king who came as a lowly servant on a donkey. He didn't come in royal robes and prancing steed. Oh no, he came humble, meek and low. Glory be to God. Jesus comes not by conquest of force as an earthly king, but he came by love. And he came by grace. Hallelujah. Mercy and his own sacrifice for the people. His is not a kingdom of armies and splendor, but of lowliness and servanthood. Hallelujah. He conquers not nations, but hearts and minds. His message is one of peace with God. Not of temporal peace. And if he had made his triumphal entry into our hearts, doesn't he reign in our hearts with peace and love? Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
As his followers, we should exhibit those same qualities. The world sees the king, the true king, living and reigning in triumph in us. There are so many parallels and so many revelations of this great entry into Jerusalem. When I think about the crowd being stirred, it talks about that word means convulse. I mean moved. When you know you're in the presence of God, something about you just got him stirred. So much the enemy was wondering, who is this? Why are they hailing him? And Jesus himself said, if these would hold their peace, Jesus, the prophet, Nazareth of Galilee. Oh, glory be to God. Traditionally, entering into the city on a donkey means that it arrives in peace rather than coming on a horse. And all of this was fulfilled that it might be fulfilled. All of this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, tell the daughter of Zion, behold, he comes. Songwriter says, riding on a cloud. Shining like the sun. Oh, glory be to God. And then those palm branches. I mean, I saw a video and I was just even moved to tears to see just the laying down and how excited they were to see his grand entrance coming into Jerusalem. Just days before, he knew his hour had come. Tell you, so much in it. There's so many revelations in it about the donkey and the garments that you put up on an unbroken donkey. When we come to the Lord, we're new. He gives us new. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. When we behold something, that means it should command our attention. When we behold something, it's something that we should admire. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud. Glory be to God. thank you,
yes,
Jesus.
God. Yes, God.
And there's an evidence of humility in this transportation.
All right.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Yeah.
And so there's so much I can share about the Dundee's place.
Yeah.
One of the things it mentioned is that it was at a crossroads passing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It was at a crossroads. And they went their way and found the colt tied by the door and without the place where two ways met.
Yeah.
And they loosed him. I got so many messages, I began to think about what's got you tied up.
Thank you. I don't know why Jesus loves me. I really don't know why he cares my
Just two more people that can stand and say why you're grateful this morning.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Praise God,
whom
all blessings flow. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Yes. I am grateful this morning to be here. And I stand to tell you that Jesus is a healer.
Ah,
he
yeah.
is the word. God is great. I remember about 3 months I didn't have any appetite to eat anything. Lost a lot of weight, but he restored my appetite. I'm eating everything.
Tell everybody, if you don't know him, get to know him. Because he's the best thing that you'll ever get to know. Okay, he's when he took on the cross, for every stripe he took, every nail he took, he called my name. God damn. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for another day, for a third day of coming this holy week. Just to praise him, just to lift him up. Just to let us know who he is and who I am.
Yeah.
I am a child of God.
That time it took me one vote. I don't want to hold nobody back. Amen.
Good morning. I stand before you very, very grateful this morning, thanking God for his keeping power. This week I made 15 years clean of crack cocaine.
I never know.
for a few moments to those who used to serve in this meeting now through the years.
God bless you this morning.
Yes.
Precious memories.
I walked in this door and I said, Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
That did not hold me in here. One day.
One day.
But not now.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I've been pretty sick. I hadn't been here in 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Well.
All right now.
And I was sharing that if I don't want to eat, do my research, or go to church, I'm sick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. But I thought about all those who came this way this morning when I woke up.
Yeah.
Amen. I thought about Moses Fuller.
Yeah. Amen.
And even names that I did not know the people, but I heard them call O.C. Trim.
Yeah.
Amen.
Judy Trim. Let me tell y'all, my sisters are preaching this morning. Judy Trim was the first woman to preach in this pulpit. Back in the 60s, early 70s.
Yes.
And Lewis Ross, Joyce Freeman,
yes,
John Connor,
yes,
Benny Cruz, Marcus
Smith,
yes,
yes,
they called the Big Three, yes, they called.
Yes.
That was a woman that was my supervisor youth. Her name was Ella Watkins.
Yes, yes. Yes.
That's right.
From New Friendship.
Yeah.
Yes. One who started our youth was Ella B. Logan from Pilgrim.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, we're blessed today.
Yes. Yes.
And the echo from heaven,
yes,
challenges us to still press on.
Yes,
I know it's not like what it used to be, but we got to press on.
That's it. That's it.
I've become these services 50 years today.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And all those who are gone on before us,
yes,
are waiting.
Yes.
Yes, they are.
They're waiting on us, y'all.
Yes.
T.E. Brown,
yes,
stands on the portal of heaven and say, go on, children.
Go on,
yes,
children.
One day we'll all get together.
Yes.
So one of these days,
yes, one of these days,
it won't be precious memories.
Yes.
It'll be high to high.
Yes.
Single and happy Boulevard.
Yes.
Yeah. This witness name, we will just call that name out before we close this out. I know I wouldn't be here for a lady named Gladys Parker.
Amen.
It woke me up in the middle of the night, many holy weeks, and I continued my sleeping on that back bench. That's why I called Kenneth Harris last night, because he took my seat where I used to sleep doing holy week. I said, oh, we got another youngster here. You come on down, and he used to call me down. You come here, and you gotta do something now. That was then. This is now. Thank God for Gladys Parker. Anybody else before we just end this out?
We
got Williams singing.
Please.
Yeah.
Joan
Pearson.
Oh, yeah.
Sarah Robinson.
Jesse Coleman.
Deacon Aberdeen.
Amen.
Brother Staples.
Katie Wallen.
Yes.
Amen.
Ruby Wall.
Amen.
Deacon Charles T. Davis.
Praise God.
Sister Jessie Davis.
Amen.
And Reverend Eddie Watt.
Reverend M. T. Elias Jackson.
Deacon Emil Owsley.
Yes.
Yes.
Can we just stand and sing one chorus, one verse of precious memories?
Yes.
that there is. And this year, we thank God. We thank God, especially for our moderator, Reverend Clifton Caldwell. Amen. The Lord gave him a vision. Amen. And for the first time in the history of this association, we will have our sisters, the women of the gospel, to come and share the gospel with us each morning. And thank God for the spirit of inclusiveness. The Bible says that in the last days, I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And trust me, they are still preaching today. And they've got a word for us from the Lord, for us to hear, that will encourage our hearts on this week. I am proud to present the song and introduce the others. She don't really need an introduction because every morning practice you see her, she's already here. Along with her wonderful husband, Moderator Ellis. Present the song and present to others the one and the only one, the Reverend Bonnie Ellis. Let the church say amen. Come on, give God praise.
Verily I say unto you, one of you which eateth with me shall betray me? And they began to be sorrowful and to say unto him one by one, is it I? And another said, is it I? And he answered and said unto them, it is one of the 12 that dippeth with me in the dish. The Son of Man indeed goeth as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. Good were it for that man if he had never been born. And as they did eat, Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said, take eat, this is my body. And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said unto them, this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many. Verily I say unto you, I will drink no more of the fruit of the vine until that day that I drink it new in the kingdom of God. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives. And Jesus said unto them, all ye shall be offended because of me this night. For it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep shall be scattered. But after that I am risen, I will go before you into Galilee. But Peter said unto him, although all shall be offended, yet will not I. And Jesus saith unto him, verily I say unto thee, that this day, even in this night, before the cock crow twice, thou shalt deny me thrice. But he spake the more vehemently, if I should die with thee, I will not deny thee in any wise. Likewise also said they all. And they came to a place which was named Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, sit ye here while I shall pray. And he taketh with him Peter and James and John, and began to be sore amazed, and to be very heavy, and saith unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful unto death. Tarry ye here and watch. And he went forward a little and fell on the ground and prayed, that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. Nevertheless, not that I will, but what thou wilt. And he cometh and findeth them sleeping, and saith unto Peter, Simon, sleepeth thou? Couldest not thou watch 1 hour? Watch ye and pray, lest ye enter into temptation. The spirit truly is ready, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed and spake the same words. And when he returned, he found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. Neither wist they what to answer him. And he cometh the third time and saith unto them, sleep on now. Take your rest. It is enough. The hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise up. Let us go. Lo, he that betrayeth me is at hand. And immediately, while he yet spake, cometh Judas, one of the 12, and with him a great multitude with swords and staves, from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders. And he that betrayed him had given them a token, saying, whomsoever I shall kiss, that same is he. Take him and lead him away safely. And as soon as he was come, he goeth straightway to him and saith, Master, Master, and kissed him. And they laid their hands on him and took him. And one of them that stood by drew a sword and smote a servant of the high priest and cut off his ear. And Jesus answered and said unto them, are ye not out? Are ye come out as against the thief with swords and with staves to take me? I was daily with you in the temple, teaching, and you took me not. But the scriptures must be fulfilled. Thank you, Lord, for the blessing that is in the reading of your word.
Amen.
All right. Have you ever taken someone into your heart? Someone you thought was a friend? Someone you could confide in, and someone who could confide in you? Have you ever taken someone into your home and fed them and housed them, and they got on their feet and turned on you? Have you ever had someone you thought loved you turn on you?
Yes.
And you wonder, what did I do?
Right.
Yeah. Have you ever had someone who thought you thought was your friend, and all of a sudden they have new friends and don't need you anymore?
Right.
Have you ever had someone lie on you and steal from you? Have you ever had someone give you one of those deceitful church kisses and say, I love you? And you know they didn't mean it. Then you kind of know how Jesus felt when Jesus betrayed. The only difference is you didn't know what they would do.
All right.
And Jesus did.
Amen. Amen.
What kind of man would know that you would betray him and make you one of his closest friends?
Yeah. All right.
The 12. What kind of man would know that you would betray him and would allow you to hold the money bag? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and would send you out to cast out devils and give you power against clean spirits and power to heal all manner of sickness and disease? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and tell you to go to the lost sheep of Israel and preach? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and give you one of the 12 baskets left over from feeding the 5,000? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and take you in the upper room and give you the Passover meal and take supper with you? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and wash your feet? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and know that you are about to betray him and tell you that you do quickly? What kind of man would know that you would betray him and would kiss you even when he knew, would know that it was a kiss of betrayal? Only the kind of man that is 100% God and 100% man. Only the kind of man that could love us until death. Only the kind of man that would take all of our sins upon himself and allow that sin and himself to be nailed to the old rugged cross. Only the kind of man that would die for the salvation of the world. Only the kind of man that would allow himself to be buried in a borrowed tomb. Only the kind of man that would stay dead for only 3 days and on the third day get up out of the grave with all power in his head and take the keys of death and hell. Only the kind of man that came to seek and to save that which was lost. No wonder they called him Jesus Christ, the Savior.
Thank you for just providing for us, okay?